Next is question 16. Now in question 16, the question is modification of petiole. Petiole get modified into leaf-like structure. Now you know that when petiole get modified into leaf-like structure, this is called as phyllode. And phyllode is found in Australian acacia. Now Australian acacia is a common name, but the scientific name is Acacia auriculoformis. So we remember petiole modification is a phyllode. Question number 17. A small aquatic herb in which a portion of leaf forms a tiny sac or a bladder. Here it is asking a leaf modification and formation of bladder. Now bladder is formed in a plant that is known as bladder wort. Now this bladder wort are also known as utricularia. So the option B becomes the correct answer. Question 18. Which of the following is not correctly matched? So not correct match that we have to identify. Now if we go with the option A, here alternate phyllotaxy, it is found in case of Mangifera indica. So it is a correct statement. Alternate is found in case of, so it is a phyllotaxy. First you should understand what is phyllotaxy. Phyllotaxy is an arrangement of leaves. It is a arrangement of leaves on stem and its branches. So this is the arrangement of leaves. Okay, so first option is alternate phyllotaxy, which is found in Mangifera indica. Correct. Option B is bold phyllotaxy, found in Cydium guazawa. Cydium guazawa is guava, and guava opposite phyllotaxy is found, wald is not found. In option C, opposite superinsert phyllotaxy is found in Eugenia. Correct. And D, opposite decussate phyllotaxy in Calotropis as well as guava. So Calotropis is given, so it is correct. Incorrect option is option B, so it is the answer. Question 19. The incorrect statement is, again we have to identify the incorrect statement. Now statement A is, in an Nepenthes, lamina forms a pitcher like structure. Yes, we have discussed before in some of the questions that the lamina get modified and form the pitcher in case of Nepenthes. So it is a correct statement. Statement B is, utricular leaves modified into bladder like, so just we have discussed, it's a correct one. Option C, opposite Drosera leaves are reproductive in nature. It is an incorrect statement, because Drosera leaves are modified into the particularly insectivorous structure and not have a reproductive role, so it is an incorrect statement. And D, bryophyllum leaves are help in vegetative propagation. We have discussed this also before some question, that bryophyllum in leaves, its leaves margin, the bud get modified into a plant and vegetative propagation occurs. So incorrect statement is option C. Next is question 20. In question 20, it asks that edible part of cauliflower. Edible part of cauliflower. Now, in cauliflower, what we eat, that is a corymb inflorescence. Which inflorescence? Corymb inflorescence. And in corymb inflorescence, what happens? This is the main axis, this is the growing axis. These are the new flower which arises from the pedicel. Now the lower pedicel are longer, due to which all the flower come and lie at the same plane, then this type of inflorescence is known as corymb. So this what we eat. So in question 20, option B become the correct answer, that is inflorescence. Question 21 asks that a man without any knowledge of botany, a man who does not know about the botany, thinks that it is a flower, but actually it is an inflorescence. So this type of stunning happens in non-botanist people. So we know that capitulum is a type of inflorescence, and in capitulum what happens, you know that there is a thalamus get modified and form a receptacle, and you will find here some of the flowers and some of the flowers here. These flowers are known as ray floret, and this flower are known as disc floret. Now if we see this diagram from the above side, it look like this, and this is nothing but a sunflower. So sunflower is an inflorescence, it is not a flower. So option B is correct, that is sunflower. Next is question 22. It asks that in an inflorescence where flower are born laterally in an acropetal succession, okay, acropetal succession, the position of youngest floral bud shall be. So we have to identify the position of younger flower. First we understand the acropetal succession. Acropetal succession is a succession in which growth happens and the flowers born. Now when younger flower are towards the apex and older flower are towards the base, then this type of is a succession or growth is known as acropetal succession. Now in this the growth is occurring towards the growing point and growth is occurring in the apex position. Now here this particular part is attached, so this is the basal portion, and here this is the distal end. So younger flower are located towards the distal end, that is option B. Next is question 23. When a large number of sessile flowers, now we remember that sessile flowers are those flowers who do not bear pedicel, means they do not have a pedicel, and pedicel is a stalk of flower, as you know this. Now sessile flowers grow from a suppressed racist, giving rise to the globose structure. When inflorescence of this globose structure, just we have studied in case of the sunflower. So this sunflower have capitulum inflorescence, so answer becomes A, that is a capitulum inflorescence. Next is question 24. Zymose inflorescence is present in. Zymose is a type of inflorescence in which flower arrange in basal petal order, that is arrangement of flower. Now if we see the example A is given as a solanum. Yes, in solanum zymose inflorescence is there. In B Sespania you will not find a solanum, you will find a particular this racemose inflorescence, C catkin, and D turmeric. So that are C trifolium and D brassica, so they are not example of zymose. A is the correct answer. Next is question 25 is a diagrammatic question which I have asked that you have to identify the inflorescence, and if you see this inflorescence is nothing but a scythium, that is option A. But I will try to explain you what is scythium. This scythium is a special type of inflorescence, it is a special type of inflorescence, and in this what happens, in this you will find a receptacle is there, and in this receptacle what happens, one single carpel is there, and this carpel come out of this, so long pedicel it has, long carpel is there and long style is there. Near about it has a unisexual male flower, and several male flower are there which are represented by just stamen. So if this type of inflorescence is found, this is known as cytium. Next is question number 26. Now question number 26 asks that when petals are free from each other as in mustard, the condition is known as, okay. So it is asking about the free petals. Now we remember when petals are free, the term is used as polypetalous, and petals are fused, then the term is used as gamopetalous. So the answer becomes polypetalous, that is option C. Next is question 27. 27 is when the margin of sepals or petals overlap one another without any particular direction. So this statement is correct with respect to the imbricate aestivation, that you should remember. Question 28 asks that bisexual flowers, example Datura, are also called as. So bisexual flower are those flower which have both stamen and carpel. Now this term can also be used as a monoecious. Monoecious means also the same thing, that male and female sex organ are present on the same plant. So the B option is the correct one. Question 29. The term polyadelphus is related to. Very good question. Polyadelphus. So first you should understand the term adelphus. Adelphus means a fusion of stamen through filament only. Anthers are not fused, only filament is fused. Now, in prefix to the adelphus, you can use a word mono, you can word as a di or a poly. If stamens are fusing through the filament and forming a one group, it is known as monoadelphus. If they are forming a two group, it is known as diadelphus. But fusion of a stamen through filament and they form a multiple group, then this term for multiple group is used, that is a polyadelphus. So it is a term for the androecium, that is option B. Next is question 30. Now question 30 asks about ovules arise from the central axis in which type of placentation. Means we have to talk about a placentation in which ovule arise from the central axis. So ovule, if arise from the central axis, this type of diagram are observed in two types of placentation. This is a exile and this is a free central. Now both have a central axis, but the question, if we go with the option, in option free central is not given, only exile is given. So B is the correct answer.